What's up, YouTube? In this episode, we're gonna go really quickly through the top five website builders for you to use in 2017. All right, guys, so like I mentioned, in this video, we're gonna talk about the top five website builders that you can use in 2017. Some of these require like absolutely no coding experience whatsoever. One of the ones that I'm gonna mention requires some coding knowledge or experience, so just bear with me and we'll get through the top five really quickly. But before we do that, make sure you subscribe to this channel. If you don't, you're missing out on tons of great information. Also, check me out on some of my other social media channels if you're looking to contact me or just get in touch with me. You can head to Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, whatever, and then just send me a personal message and I'll get back with you as quickly as I can. I usually get back like same day. So, you know, I don't think anybody else does that but me, but leave me messages. I'll talk to you. Anyways, let's get into the top five website builders. So really quick, we have them all right here for 2017. Okay. The first one is going to be Wix, and it's a easy to use website builder. A lot of small businesses use this because they can go in and easily use their templated builder to plug and play basically everything they need for a website to be functioning and working properly. The next one is going to be Weebly. Weebly is basically the exact same thing as Wix. They do have minor differences. Some cater to better to like designers and artists, while some cater better to businesses that are more corporate oriented. So you know, there's differences between all the sites. Just go check each one out, look at the templates mainly, and look at the features offered as far as customer service, and we're gonna go into a bunch of the things that you should look for in this video. Next is going to be Shopify, and Shopify is great for e-commerce stores. I honestly don't suggest looking at any other platform if you're doing a business that's selling products online, just because of the amount of, I guess, usability, or the user interface is super awesome to use for anybody who doesn't understand, number one, how to code, number two, how to implement tracking and other types of features into their website, like email marketing and remarketing. All of that comes really easy with Shopify because they have a whole app suite of people that they partner with to plug those apps directly into their Shopify templates. And it makes it really easy to run an e-commerce store. Next, we'll go over Squarespace. And Squarespace is also more familiar or more similar to Weebly and Wix. The difference in this one is, again, this one is actually more for artists and people who are, you know, do personal pages, stuff like that, that are trying to look more appealing, visually appealing. Squarespace does the job great. They have a ton of great templates and artistic templates already built out for you to take advantage of. Last, and then definitely not least, is gonna be WordPress. Now, this is the one that I was talking about that takes a little bit more coding experience to do a good job, or to actually be able to work inside of their platform. So you will need to understand some basic coding knowledge to work inside of there. If you've never worked on a website before, it's gonna make it very difficult for you to put together a good WordPress site. So I wouldn't recommend starting here if you've never done it before, but if you're looking for, you know, to build a client a site, if you're looking to build them, you know, a really good site that's going to do really great for SEO, as well as just visually appealing and something that they'll be able to manage, I recommend hiring a WordPress developer. If you aren't a developer yourself, most of us aren't. I'm not a developer. So if you're not a developer, I recommend looking into hiring a WordPress developer so they can put the site together for you. It makes it easy for your customers to be able to use if they need to go in and make updates or changes, and it makes it really great as far as the structure and architecture of the site. They're very clean to use because you can use straight up coding. And any of the coding that you don't use, you can easily adjust. It's just very easy to customize things with WordPress. Whereas using these other builders, since you're using templates, it makes it hard to make changes to the custom coding, or the coding that exists for the body or the main structure of the site. So keep that in mind. If you're trying to take a site and over the next, you know, year, 2 years, you plan for it to expand and grow even more, you might want to go ahead and just start with a WordPress site. Otherwise, you will have to take these sites and convert them over and make changes later, which can be a hassle. It costs money. So you will end up spending some money to do that. So those are the top five that you're going to look at for this year. But what do you want to look out for when you use these types of website builders? Because that's the most important thing. These are the top five, but what should you be looking for when you're actually, you know, trying to pick which platform you want to start with? So we're going to hop on over screen share. Screen share basically what we have put together on what to consider for buying or purchasing website builders or using a website building service. So number one is going to be functionality. Just consider what features and functionality your website will not only currently need, but also need in the future. So again, like I was just saying, if you plan to expand on your site, if you plan to add a whole online inventory in the future where you sell products online in the future, you're going to want to take that into consideration because making changes on a basic site builder like Wix or Weebly or Squarespace, it can be very difficult to make those custom changes that you're looking for later, especially if your business becomes more complex or if your client's business is going to become more complex in the future. You'll want to actually, take that into consideration in choosing the builder. You don't just want to go with the cheapest option, especially because it will end up costing you more money in the future to make those changes. The next one is going to be reachable customer service. This is super important because when you have issues when using their website builder, you can't find answers from a community or something like that, you want a reachable customer service backend side from these website builders. So that's a key thing to keep in mind. So look for reviews on each one's customer service and make sure you find the one that's going to work best for you. Fully responsive website templates. This is important because you want it to not only work for mobile screens, but you want it to adjust to a desktop or tablet screen as well. So if they're not, fully responsive, mobile optimized or desktop optimized, but the real term is fully responsive. That's a developer term that you'll become familiar with. But a fully responsive website has to be a key feature for the website builder because, people are on their phones and on desktop these days. We can't just limit the sizing to one. It makes for a bad user experience. Search engine optimization friendly. So the best thing about these is it allows you to plug in page titles, keywords to pages, links, all kinds of stuff. And it has little sections on each page that you build where you can plug those keywords and all of that SEO data into. So make sure that whichever one you pick, you do pick one of the platforms that allows you to do a lot of SEO customization for your site. Ease of use is going to be another one. So you want to be able to just go in and plug things where they need to go on the website. And really with ease of use, it's referencing more to designing the website. So it needs to be easy to actually go in and place buttons in places and place images that are going to fit properly and make sure that, carousels are working if you have those on your site. Anything about using the website builder itself, if you place products online, you want to make sure, or if you're selling products online and you're not going to go, say, the Shopify route, you might want to check out the other website builders and see, okay, well, is this going to be effective to use? Or should I just, suck it up and learn how to do Shopify? Just depends, right? Free of banner ads, and this is important because they just don't look good, okay? If you have a bunch of banner ads on your website, it looks like you're an advertising site. But if you have no banner ads, it makes you look more organic, more natural, more real. So if you've ever been to like a news website, you'll notice that they usually are running banner ads across their website. And that's why a lot of people won't use their sites. They'll get their news and information elsewhere. And it's because of the fact that they're running banner ads constantly across those because that's how they generate revenue. Or that's one of the ways that they generate revenue. So if you're doing it for, say, a doctor, you don't want banner ads on this doctor's website. There should never be a banner ad on a doctor's website unless he is a doctor that is also a thought leader. So he has like a million followers on Facebook or Instagram, something like that. That would be the only time you want banner ads, and that's because he gets millions of followers or views every single month, so you can monetize off of that. But if it's a very small practice, you don't want banner ads, okay? The capacity to export your website. So this means just to make backups, to easily change data or to transfer it over to another website in the future. That's an important factor. So if you do want to start off small, make sure that you're able to remove all of your old information from it. You want clean and well-written HTML and CSS code. And this is why I was saying that WordPress is better, because of the fact that these are templates, and they're built. So like Weebly, Wix, Squarespace, all of these, what they're using a template. So that means all of the coding inside of it is already pre-built. And that doesn't necessarily mean that it's going to be the best quality possible for SEO. That's why clean and well-written HTML and CSS is, important with regards to building a website and search engine optimization. So if you're not familiar, just really quick, I left some links here if you have no idea what I mean when I say HTML or CSS. CSS means the design, HTML is the actual logic and coding behind it. So You know, you can just briefly look at these. It goes way deeper than that, but you know, that's just a general understanding of it for someone who's never heard of it. But you do want it to be clean and well written. That's why WordPress is better, because of the fact that you're able to customize everything, all of the code inside of it. Makes it to where you can actually clean it up and get rid of any code that isn't necessary. Monthly, annual cost, and refund policy. So obviously that's a factor when you're looking at it. You want to make sure that you're able to spend a cost-effective amount. Template customization, that's another thing. Again, that's why WordPress is one of the better ones, because you're actually able to customize everything about the template. Some of them don't allow you to get in and change a lot of the things because they work in what's called a liquid template. And a liquid template means that they're actually taking information from somewhere else and just plugging in a back-end series that just relays information. That's all it does. So it's hard to explain if you've never heard of coding or talked about it before. So I could go, it would literally take me an hour to get you to have a complete understanding just talking about that. So we'll just leave it at that. Just know that you want to look, and if you're not sure, talk to the customer support. Ask them, what is your customization like? Look for reviews online from people who have talked about it before. And then additional goodies and extras, find what additional offerings your website builder offers to its customers, like SEO help or credits for ads and marketing. Some of them will give you like $100 Google ad or pay-per-click ad coupon or something like that if you work with them. There's tons of them. Shopify gives you a free 30-day trial or something like that, or 21-day trial if you find some of those. You know, there's all kinds of different promotions that you can look for when, you know, just starting with these sites. Also, they'll give you promotions, like they'll give you a free domain sometimes if you purchase their website or use their website builder. You know, there's all kinds of stuff that you can check out, but that's just for you guys. So anyways, that's basically it for this quick episode. Again, I told you I would keep this one relatively short. It's about the top five website builders out there. Make sure if you haven't done research on this before and you're about to start a website or build a website or look into, you know, doing website consulting, look into these five website builders, because your customers will be using them and you want to know how to talk to them about it. You want to act or at least seem like you've been in the platform before. So that way when you go in, it makes you seem more credible. If you go into these customers and you're like, hey, oh yeah, I've never used Wix. Well, then you automatically don't look like you've been involved in the industry long enough, right? So get in there and try all of them out. So that way, at least if a potential customer asks you if you've worked in it before, you can say, yeah, I've done some work in it before. And you're not lying to them. You're being very straight up and honest about it. So anyways, those are just my quick tips on finding a website builder. I hope this was helpful for you guys. As always, if you haven't subscribed, check out serialentrepreneur.academy to check out the blog article on this. And as always, follow my social media links, which are going to be below, so that way you can get in contact with me and keep up with the latest promotions and offers and information that I'm releasing to you guys. We also have our monthly mentorship program. I always like to throw that out there. If you're looking for a guide or someone to help you along with your marketing for your business or for your agency, just let me know. We have that over again at serialentrepreneur.academy. You can sign up for that. It's only $20 a month, so super cheap, and you get access directly to me. So that's it for this episode, guys. I hope you enjoyed everything. I'll see you on the next one. Serial Entrepreneur Jordan Steen out.